This video, we're going to look at the song Beginnings by Chicago, a great song, and a great song for the acoustic guitar and electric guitar, but I'm going to use the acoustic guitar today because that's a pretty predominant part in the song, and it's almost a song of major seven chords, so not only learning the song, but maybe you'll get to take a few major seven chords along with you after the video if you see some new grips that you might want to learn. Let's look at the intro, then we're going to look at what goes on through the verse. And I guess you'd say kind of a pre-chorus or chorus part, and then the outro, which is literally almost half of the song, and it's three chords. So we'll knock this one out today, and you'll be able to add this to your list. Let's look at the intro. As you can see, it's one chord shape in two different positions. We're going to learn it here initially like this. 13th fret G string, first finger, 14th fret D using my middle finger, ring finger on the B string 14th fret. So it's at this little kind of a triangle shape. We're not playing the low E string, but all the rest. We're going to move that down two frets, to 12 and 12 on D and B, and 11 on G. Again, strumming the same five strings, A through high E. Okay, that's the intro. It's also a part of the song that gets repeated between verses and other parts of the song, so you'll know, obviously, when it goes back to that lick. Okay, now let me give you a suggestion while we're here. Since I've just shown it to you using 1, 2, and 3, I'm going to suggest another way to play it, and I'll show you why. Maybe if it's a doable situation for you, use your second finger on the G string, ring finger, and pinky to get the D and the B string. So your first finger is not doing anything in this position. Seems a little odd here, but let me show you the reason for that. Let's go on into the verse, and I'll play what's going on through the verse, and then we'll break it down. Okay, let's stop there for now. Okay, the two chord grips that I used here on the verse was an A major 7, basically an A grip with the G string moved down to the first fret. So I'm using first finger G string, first fret, second finger, second fret of the D, B string, second fret using my ring finger. A pretty chord. We're going from that chord to a D major 7, barring A through E on the fifth fret with my first finger. Second finger is getting the G string 6th fret, ring finger 7th fret of the D, B string 7th fret with my pinky. Okay, if you can visualize this, I'm essentially just moving the same grip up 5 frets. If I think of my finger as the nut, okay, this is the same grip that we used on the intro. So we can really and in watching Chicago, this is how at least one of their guitar players plays it. So we can kind of steal from them. Then into the verse. So if that's a comfortable position for you, you can move from the intro down here without ever lifting your fingers off the strings. It almost seems like cheating, but we'll cheat every chance we get when we're playing guitar. So my fingers have never left the strings. I can continue to keep them on the strings, sliding them into the D major 7, and then throwing down the bar. So I can lock into this one position if I'm using 2, 3, and 4, and play the intro and most of the verse. got the idea. It can certainly be played with the first, second, and third finger, and then move into that grip. And that's doing exactly the same way. It's just a matter of what feels comfortable to you, and I think it's pretty efficient to leave those fingers on the strings if you can. Another voicing that I want to show you before we leave this part is this A major 7. Open A string, 7th fret D, right down the row. 6th fret G, 5th fret B, 4th fret high E. It's a great voicing, and I actually see a guitar player in the band playing this grip as well. Okay, so either way definitely works. If you're playing with another person, I would take a grip, and another will take the other voicing, and it sounds really big that way. The root note in this chord is with the pinky, so you can move it around. If you know your D string, you know what chord you're playing. Here it's an A major 7, so we can grab the A string as well. So those are your two options on that. From this A major 7 to D major 7, the next progression is just to slide down 2 frets to a C major 7. So we're barring the 3rd fret, A through E, 4th fret G, 5th fret of the D and the B string. Okay, so that's, it kind of builds there. Two chord grips there. The C that we began with, this major 7 that we just learned, down 2 frets, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, and 5th. Not playing the A string because it's not going to work here. Just playing top 4 strings. Okay, and toggling back and forth. One other option is to take this grip that we've already worked with and move it up to the 10th fret, barring 10, A through E, 11th fret G, 12th fret D, and B. And instead of grabbing this G major 7, we're going to get this G major 7. So, same chord, different voicing. And actually, in watching Chicago perform it live, the lead singer does toggle between these two positions. In the studio version, I hear this position and I kind of prefer it. But who am I to tell him he's wrong? After that, it goes back to the intro. And then a slight change, the part where they're singing, I believe it's silence. Go back to our friend, the A major 7. Then just a good old E minor. This is also another good place to use this voicing of A major 7. Whichever one your ear likes. That leaves us with just the outro of the song, which is maybe the easiest, which is good because it's about half of the song. It's essentially kind of an F chord in a way, but with the high E string open. I definitely hear this on the studio version. So the first position is an A. I'm wrapping my thumb around to get the E string 5th fret, 7th fret of the A and the D, 6th fret of the G, 5th fret of the high E string, or the B string rather, and high E string open. Move that down 2 frets, same position, again with the high E string open, down to first position, first fret, not changing anything with my left hand other than moving it in 2 fret increments, and then back up. That's it. You could certainly just emphasize the top 4 strings if the thumb over the top was too much for you. Or even add the pinky. finally all six strings with a thumb. It covers all the great rhythm guitar parts of Beginnings by Chicago. Hope you enjoy working it up. Thanks for watching the video.